So there we are. Okay. That's your sport. Good luck to all our teams this weekend.
Take a look at that. Starch collar. You left your washing downstairs, so I brought it back up. Had a bit of a go myself. It looks good, doesn't it? Is it yours?
Oh, I'm sure it is.
Try it.
Yeah.
I had no idea you were a dedicated follower of fashion.
Yes, I was going to say thank you. You did a nice job on this one tonight as well for me. Thank you.
It's a pleasure. Pleasure. Anytime. Do you know, the art of producing a starch collar just like this was almost lost. But apparently it's now thriving at Barker's Laundry in Bournemouth. And Sarah Farmer's been along to inspect the laundry. You can do that one if you like.
At the turn of the last century, starching collars was big business. The detachable fabric gave a clean, sharp finish to formal wear without the expense of washing a full shirt.
So you might have one shirt that could be worn for the whole week, but you'd change your collars every day, once every 2 days. So you'd be producing an awful lot of collars to launder.
Prominent historical figures like Albert Einstein and Charlie Chaplin were rarely seen without one.
At the turn of the last century, there were something like 6,000 laundries in the UK at that time.
Today, business may not be as big, but a Bournemouth laundry is helping to keep the niche neckwear alive.
And when I started doing it, we were doing 10 or 15 collars a week, and we're now doing in excess of 1,500 collars a week.
Kitty Colthurst, Sarah Bunting. Miss Bunting's a teacher.
It's dramas like Downton Abbey which are to thank for a spike in business. The period characters Poirot and Mr. Selfridge also wear authentic collars. Even blockbusters like Titanic and Sherlock Holmes have relied on the Barker Group to provide the finishing touches to their costumes.
It's a very long process, although it doesn't take a long time. There are 60 separate individual elements of that process. And if you cut out one part of that process, you won't get the proper finished product.
This is how they start.
Yes, these are the raw collars after being washed at 90 degrees.
Into the starch they go.
How many do you do at a time?
It's normally in batches of 50. Give them a good ring.
Then onto the press at 200 degrees to give the collars their shine and rigidity.
And this piece of equipment looks pretty old-fashioned.
Yes. I wouldn't like to say how old it is. Making silk out of cotton, I suppose.
I was very fortunate. A customer put me in touch with a lady called Alice Allen, who lived in London, and since the age of 13, she had been producing collars for a laundry in London, and she was 83. So every summer, for a week, for 3 years, I'd bring her down to Bournemouth, and she would come into the factory and teach us how to do the perfect collar.
What on earth is she doing here?
I asked her. Cora said I could.
So the next time you nestle in to watch the ups and downs of the Grantham household, pay close attention to the costumes and bear in mind the Bournemouth company adding a dash of debonair to Downton.
I'd no idea they were still back in fashion, though.
I know, it was quite a sight, actually, to see them all piled up high, rows and rows and rows of them. They produce about 80,000 in the course of a year.
It's incredible, isn't it, from this to this?
West End,
fantastic.
Yeah, West End and films using them all the time.
Good, that's great.
Amazing.
OK, on